Using GeoBoard to make tessellation patterns, like the artist M.C. Escher. The first one we're looking at today is a series of hexagons and triangles. Last week, we looked at how to make a hexagon.
And I know how to make a hexagon.
It got six sides. A hexagon is a polygon, a flat two-dimensional shape with six sides. When we're making our hexagons and GeoBoard, make sure that you use one rubber band for each hexagon and pull it open wide so that you can fill it with color. Notice how I'm repeating the hexagon over and over again like the tessellation pattern on the board. All of our hexagons are touching corner to corner and they are repeating in a geometric pattern. Tessellations are geometric patterns with congruent sides. That means their sides, the sides of the shapes that touch, must be equal. So when we come back in to put our rhombuses in, these are actually a pair of equilateral triangles. I'm going to do one blue one and one purple one, like the ones on the board. One blue one, one purple one. Blue on top, purple on the bottom. Notice I'm opening up these bands as I make each one. Allow me to finish making this first row and then we'll address questions. One blue one and one purple one. Now the reason I'm opening these bands up is so that we can use the fill button to fill them all with color to create a design like the one we see down here on the board. Then we come back with another row of hexagons above that to create this true tessellation pattern. So my triangles must have sides that are equal to that side of the hexagon, and I can fill those with color. That is one tessellation pattern using regular polygons, hexagons, and equilateral triangles.